Welcome back. As we earlier said, as we're beginning a new year with aspirations full of prosperity, full of hopes, full of ambition, free of pandemics and youthful and healthy, we also would think of how we could look. We're full of ambitions to look at our best, to be healthy, to be prosperous and to be glowing. And this would require some beauty tips and some health tips at the same time. Today, we have a beauty expert and a makeup expert at the same time, Yumna Al-Qatari, and she's here live with us in the studio. She's going to talk to us about the latest trends in makeup, about the latest trends on how to look good and glowy with the least touches of makeup. Not too much, I hope. The fashion for looking good for 2021. Good morning, Ms. Al-Qatari. Let's first talk about the trend of looking good. Let me not say makeup, because some people wouldn't like to wear makeup all the time, but just looking good, some touches. What is the trend? What are the latest colors?
Okay, in winter 2020, or we can say 2021, as we're starting 2021.
We're off with
2020, yes. The makeup trends are going all towards the no makeup makeup or the very light makeup, and we've been seeing this in the summer as well. But in winter, the main colors that are taking the trend are like the light purples, the light pinks, or the nudes, and we're going as well to the direction of the matte and the colors of the makeup, not mainly the glittery colors or the shimmery colors. As well, the foundation is not a trend anymore in the daily makeup or in our makeup.
What do we wear instead?
Instead, we wear BB cream or CC cream, which has a light or lighter coverage than the foundation and still gives a very healthy and natural look to the face. So this works instead of the foundation, because you know, layers of makeup and heavy foundation is no longer a trend in 2021. So a lighter foundation or lighter coverage for the BB cream and the CC cream is mainly the trend now, and lighter colors, and as well the matte makeup is going as a trend right now. No more shimmers and glitters in the winter season.
So no more shimmer. Shimmer would look very nice. Shimmer, the highlighter, you mean?
No, not the highlighter. I mean the shimmer in the eyes, the glitter eyeshadows.
It's too much.
It's too much, and it's heavy in makeup. It has been a trend in winter a bit, but in summer a bit. But in winter, I don't think it's going to be trendy anymore, because it doesn't suit the look of the light foundation. If we're going to give a light coverage and a very simple look, glittery eyes will give, you know, a very heavy look for the eyes.
But what about the glittery or the highlights with the blushes?
Yes, highlighter. Highlighter is a trend that will never die.
It gives a glow.
Yes, it gives a glow, but there's types of highlighters. Sometimes you do a cream highlighter, and sometimes you do a powder highlighter, and this depends on the effect that you're going to get from the highlighter. We recommend powder highlighters because it's lighter than the creamy one. The creamy highlighter gives a very, very clear show, or a very, very clear look of highlighter. You look very glowy. But for morning, we recommend as well powder highlighters.
Right. Mm-hmm. Of course, you came and you gave us some also looks for what you have been creating. I guess we can see some of them.
Yes.
If you'd like to comment.
Sure. This was a soiree makeup look. It includes full highlighter, and it includes
this is evening makeup.
Yes, this was an evening makeup. For the eyes, as you can see, it was a trend in the summer to have smudged eyeliner, to have the eyeliner as it is, but not edgy. It's smudged in the rest of the eye with powders or eyeshadows, so it gives the look, it makes the look more blended into together over the eyes.
Right. Let me also talk to you about the common problems, with which are the bumpy, circles under the eyes, and the dark circles at the same time, the pimples, the some wrinkles, some shades, the blemishes, and all these problems. How do we deal with them? Should we cover them entirely, or should we just accept it and look natural?
Okay, firstly, we need to treat anything in our skin, whether it's dark circles or pimples or any issues in the skin or breaks in the skin. This should be treated. But in makeup, we have a solution for everything. So about the under eyes, or the bags under the eyes, we call it. Okay, for the makeup, the correction it's going according to a wheel of colors, as every color corrects another color. So for example, the under eyes, it's normally blue or gray for the circles under the eyes. This is correct?
Blue or green?
Yes.
Sometimes you see people wearing, peach foundation.
Yes, it's not peach. Yes, this is the corrector for the under eyes, and it's orange for correcting the dark color. This is the color
orange.
Of the, yes, orange. The orange color corrects any blue or dark or gray circles. But the orange corrector is no longer a trend, because it's very heavy as well. So nowadays we, replaced the orange corrector with a dark concealer. Before, to correct the under eyes, we put orange corrector and then we put a light concealer to look healthy. Mm. Nowadays, we're not mainly using the orange corrector. We only use it for the people who have very dark circles. But normally we use as a concealer two shades darker than the skin color to highlight the under eyes, and then we put...
So it's two shades darker?
Yes. Two shades darker.
To highlight?
To cover the dark circles.
But it would dark still.
Then we put another concealer on it, which is two shades lighter than the skin. Okay. So this gives the highlighting.
And would that reflect wrinkles?
No, for the wrinkles, we need to use an eye cream. It wasn't known, honestly, but it's very important to hydrate the under eyes because it helps with the makeup, how it looks for the under eyes. If there is wrinkles, it hides it. It even helps with correcting the under eyes. So yes, you need to hydrate the under eyes. We need to use an eye cream, especially in winter, before putting makeup. It will help in correcting and hiding the wrinkles and the dark circles.
We need to talk about the main features, which is much more important because we have very little time. Before the makeup, before anything, the priority of the main outlines of the looks, like the shape of the eyebrows, the how would the lashes look like, how would be the blushers be taken over the face, or the color of blushes, the color of the foundation or the powder for this year. Let's talk about something like the eyebrows. Are they thick this year for 2020?
Yes, eyebrows has been having a trend for a year now, which are the bushy eyebrows, maybe like
bushy.
Mine. Yes.
I love that term.
Thank you so much. This is about brushing the eyebrows upwards, so it gives you a look which is a natural look.
Thick.
About, yes, not like, you know, the heavy brows that we used to have
in the
last years. Yes, we've been having it in 90s, I think.
The Madonna eyebrows.
Yes, yes. And in 90s, we had the tattoo brows as a trend, but it's no longer a trend now. We had the microblading instead. But for makeup, what gives the microblading look is to brush the brows upwards. And there is a trick that we do, is that you use a soap, a transparent soap.
Soap?
Yes, soap that we wash our face with. You get a transparent soap, whether glycerin or any kind of soap. You use the brush, you brush your brows with first on the soap, and then you brush it. It makes the hair of the brows stick.
Waxed.
Yes. And it never moves all over a day, and it keeps your brows
But then they would fall if you don't wash.
Never.
But at the same time, if people have very light brows, so what do they do?
Okay, for light brows, we have been using powders for brows, because this gives the most full look. But the brows pencils are now a trend. There is a range of brows pencils in all the brands with very thin pencil that you can draw with it hair strokes. So you can draw the hairs by yourself one by one, even if it's not there. So at the end, you have full brows as if it's already full.
What is the exact shape for 2020? A full, a thick,
the bushy long brows.
The bushy brows.
The bushy brows has been a trend for a year, and I think it's going to continue in 2021.
To continue.
Yes.
All right. But what about also people? Some girls would have a problem with their eyelashes, because not everyone has those thick, curled eyelashes. Some were born naturally with curled eyelashes. Most of the people do not have that.
Yes, most of us don't have full lashes because, you know, we put a lot of mascara. So this
even without wearing mascara.
Yes, we don't have that much of heavy lashes. Nowadays, lashes extensions is a trend. So many people do it, and it lasts for a month. Other than that, you can put false lashes. And it has been very easy nowadays.
What is the difference between
The extensions is a hair by hair lash. It's a lash that you put one by one, and it's normally, a lashes salon with an expert for lashes. But the false lashes is one lash that you put as an...
Both of them, you stick them.
Yes, both of them you stick them, but the extensions lashes, the one by one, it stays for a month or 3 weeks. But the false lashes, the one you put, stays for, I mean, people remove it after one day, but when I put it for my brides or my clients, it could stay for a week or something because I use a certain glue that make the lashes stay longer. Mm. So the false lashes now, people are doing it more than before. It has been easier. There's so many brands now that has false lashes and it's very easy to apply as well.
But in that case, excuse me, mm-hmm. in that case, how would we deal with, I mean, the makeup removers of the eyeshadow and the eyeliners and everything mm-hmm. when I'm wearing those eyelashes, I mean, the one by
yes.
one?
Okay, honestly, we have been removing our makeup very long for years because people, when they move their makeup, they wipe. They wipe whatever is on their face, even the eyes, they wipe it. And this makes the skin to fall down by time and gets us wrinkles. Mm. The best way to remove your eye makeup is to get a cotton pad, the circled one, to put makeup remover on it, to cover it with makeup remover, and to put it on your eye and leave it for 2 minutes.
Once, and then you...
Yes, once
and
you
then
remove
I'll
the pad...
Then I'll have to wipe.
No, you won't wipe. You'll just put it and press on for 5 minutes. Once you remove it, you'll find all the makeup in it and nothing is on your eye.
Even if I'm wearing those yes. false lashes?
Yes.
It won't fall down?
No, sure. It won't fall because it's sticked already. It's put with glue. So makeup removal will remove it only if you wiped. If you put it and you drag it down or you drag it out. Mm. But if you put it and pressed on and left it for 5 minutes, when you remove it, you'll find all the makeup in it and you don't need to wipe anything. And nothing will happen to the lashes.
Can we repeat this process for 3 times, for example, so that we can
Yes, we can,
it?
But honestly, if you left it for 3 to 4 minutes, it will wipe or it will remove all the makeup from the first time.
Mm. 3 to 4 minutes is quite a long time. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, also, some other, I mean, it's the most common questions, even most importantly, more than makeup, is how to remove the makeup. Mm-hmm. Some, like you said, wipe their faces, which is
yes.
not good or healthy
Hurts
at all.
The skin.
Some would use their makeup removal, milky solutions, which is good, but the quality of the cream is important.
Yes.
And some would use the organic formulas, like the coconut.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But coconut is very greasy.
It's
so
very heavy on the skin.
Is it healthy and it's good? Which is the best thing?
Okay, honestly, the
from
any,
1 to 4.
I will always go for any organic product. It's always the best for the skin. And
can you give us a formula that you could fix at home, so we can use it? I mean, is there any quick formula, coconut and something, and we can just use it so that we can wipe our faces with?
Okay, coconut oil, and if you put on it a few drops of your makeup remover. Mm. Okay, in a bottle, a spray bottle, and you put it on the pad, it will give you the same effect. Mm. Mm-hmm. I mean, oils has in their texture the ability to remove anything on the face. But the makeup remover gives it the clean finish, if you understand what I mean. Because the makeup remover is anyways for removing the makeup. So you'll be using an organic oil and at the same time using the makeup remover with it, so it will give you the same effect.
Because usually people complain of the coconut oil, their complaint is that it's very sticky.
Honestly, yes, and the organic oils needs to be described by a doctor, I believe, or someone who create natural or organic mixtures for us to use. That's why I recommend the branded toners that we can buy from the pharmacy or something, because they cannot hurt the eye. They are made for sensitive eyes and sensitive skin, so it will never break your skin or give you any effect other than removing the makeup.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Other questions like the color of lipsticks, are they glossy, are they matte, what is the are they earth toned, are they glowy, are they glittery? So these are also questions because lips are very important.
Yes.
This might look a little bit strange to men who are watching us right now.
Yes, but it's very important.
It would be very important of importance to women.
Yes. Okay. Honestly, nowadays there is a new trend called the tint. Okay?
Tint, yes.
Tint, yes. Tint.
Not everybody likes
it. Not everybody likes it. I don't like it, honestly.
But tints, we wear them over our cheeks.
It's for cheeks and lips. Okay? So this is something that girls go to nowadays, but it's working for university, it's working for everyday work.
Teenagers.
People, yes, yes. People who stay, you know, from the beginning to the end of the day with makeup. So makeup tints are a trend now that people put on cheeks and lips and they give them a healthy look and they work with it. But lips trend, it has been the glossy lips a trend for a long time. It's back a trend and it, as
Again?
It was before. Yes, in 2020, gloss lips has been a trend all over the year. And I think it's going to continue in 2021. But for the colors, the nudes have been a trend for a long time now. nudes like nude beiges or like purples or cashmere. Any tone of these colors is a trend nowadays, shades of purple, shades of pink, but mainly nudes. The beige is taking a number one place in this competition for the lips. And as I mentioned, the gloss as well is a trend nowadays. We got as well the trend of the lip liners, as we lost it some time lining the lips before makeup.
Probably with the advent of, you know, events and pandemics and everything, and the speed of time.
Yes.
We won't have the time for even lip liners.
Lining, yes, yes. But
don't you think so?
I think so, and I don't do it a lot, honestly. But let me tell you that lip liner is one of the tricks that make the lipstick last for the longest time possible. Let me tell you about a makeup trick for the lips, of how to put a lipstick and to get it last for the full day. First thing is that you need to scrub your lips, okay?
Scrub the lips.
Yes, and we can do it at home. Ah. It's very easy. You can put brown sugar on honey. That's it. And keep scrubbing your lips for like 2 minutes. Then put...
Would that be also used for the face, brown sugar and honey?
Not always, because some people have sensitive skin, so it doesn't always work. Sometimes
because most importantly, people would look over... I'm sorry into jumping into the question. But also talking about the good scrub that would remove all the black pores.
Yes.
So people prefer the homemade scrubs.
Yes.
But it is... not everyone has a full idea about how to make it at home.
Yes, nowadays there's so many videos about, you know, in the COVID quarantine, people went viral in creating
the like most destructive
recipes for natural masks and scrubs. But the brown sugar works as a scrub with oil, with honey.
Could it be crystal sugar instead of brown? Because brown doesn't look like a good idea.
Brown is better than white sugar in scrubbing, but it can be used white sugar. But for face, I recommend brown sugar with honey, and you can put with it any moisturizing oil for your face. Your moisturizer or your moisturizing oil, you can put it with this mixture for scrubbing your face. But for people who has dry skin or sensitive skin, they would rather get to the doctor before it or get themselves scrubbed from the pharmacy for sensitive skin to make sure
it does not need it home.
No. I mean, sensitive skin needs to check everything before they do it, because they can easily get affected from anything to the skin.
Right.
Yes.
Going back to the lips.
Yes.
So why would you scrub our lips?
Scrub to remove any dead skin on the lips. You know, when any of us get to put lipstick, you find these chips and you find this dead skin going away. So you need first thing to scrub it, to remove it, to make sure that your lips are clean and they have nothing on it. Okay? And then you put lip balm. We all have lip balms at home.
Of course.
Or any lip balm you have, you need to put it to moisturize the lips. After this, cover your lips with the lip liner.
Okay,
not only line it out, cover it all with the lip liner. Okay, and after this, put your lipstick on it.
Wouldn't that be too heavy?
Nope, at all, because you put only one layer of lipstick instead of, you know.
But what about people who would love to have that plumpy?
That's why we use the lip liners, because you can draw your lips and you can make it look different. And I will tell you another thing about making the lips look plumpy. After you put you cover your lips with lip liner, you put your lipstick. And then I put, for example, purple, and I want it plumpy. So I have one of two options, whether to get a concealer or a beige lipstick and to put it in the middle of the lips, upside and downside, okay?
Okay.
And then blend it with your finger on the lips. It will give you the plumpy look.
Okay.
Okay, you will find your lips lighter from the inner side and having the normal color from the outside, so it will have the plumpy look of the lips.
That would take us to another important, corner, which is the makeup tricks, contouring and, you know, plumping your, plumping the lips and, you know, enlarging the eyes and narrowing the nose and everything. These are very, very common and also very, very important now.
Yes.
They're very much requested by people. So talk to us quickly about elaborately, if you like to elaborate, over contouring. I mean, a very full face, the jawline, you know, the fashion is the jawline over here and the chin and everything. How do we do that?
Okay.
And what do you use?
Yes, sure. Okay, contouring depends on the face shape. Where we need to take any face shape, we need to take it to be contoured. We need to take all the face shapes to only one shape, the shape that has the bones showing up, the shape that has the jawline, as you mentioned,
and the chin.
And the chin to make it longer or to hide the double chin or to make the forehead looks smaller or to narrow the nose. We start with cream contouring. You should start with cream contouring. Okay, for narrowing the nose, we use the dark contour to hide whatever the part of the face we don't want to show.
Not the palette?
It could be a palette that has different shades of contouring, or a contouring cream, I mean one shade. It depends if you have your shade or if you have a palette, okay? So what you do, for example, for the nose, if I have the nose white from here, I need to contour this part to make it look thinner. If I have the nose tall, I need to put contouring here to lift it up.
If I have it wide, I
contour the wide areas. If I have it long, I contour it from the down area. Mm. Okay, if I have it from here wide, I contour this area only. Mm. Okay, so it makes you subconsciously, when you look to my nose, you see
it will minimize it.
Yes.
Okay.
For the forehead, if you have a white forehead, you contour it from here. You need to put contour here, so when this is darker, it will look wider. This will get in.
Okay.
For the face, you need to get to the bone next to your ear. Okay. This is where you need to show the cheeks.
Okay.
So this is where you're going to contour.
Oh.
Okay. If I want to make the face look more round, I will contour it like this.
Okay.
If I want it to look taller or thinner.
Thinner.
I will contour it like this.
Okay.
Down. Okay. Mm. Because when I contour it in a round, it lifts the cheeks up. So it gives the face a more round shape. But when I contour it down, it never gives you a cheeks. It makes your face look thinner and more contoured from the side. Okay, for the jawline, if you have this area like double chin or something, we can contour all of this.
Who would see here?
No, not for who will see here. Okay, I, for example, have a double chin. If I contoured it and you look to me, you will see nothing here.
Okay.
Okay, it depends on the effect you have in your eye. So for contouring the jawlines, if I have double chin here, I can contour it from this place, and if I want to show after contouring here the cheeks, I already put contour here. I put here highlight.
Here highlight.
Yes,
beneath the contour.
Oh. So when
and wouldn't it enlarge this part?
No, because I put above the bone of the jawline, not on it.
Mm.
If you understand what I mean, when I put above it, this shows up more.
Mm.
It doesn't fade on the opposite. Okay. Yes, it shows up more. What else we could talk about the eyes. To make the eyes look wider, there is the trend of the beige eyeliner that we put inside the eyes. Yeah. Not the white, because the white gives a scary look, I think, when I look to someone who has...
And very artificial.
Yes, it looks scary. So we mainly goes for the beige, for only the wide eyes, because it doesn't, suit any kind of eyes. So we put beige. The other thing we do now is the cat eyeliner that lifts the eyes up from here. So when we put eyeliner, if we have a wide eye, this will lift it up. And as well about contouring, or not contouring, highlighting. When we highlight these areas for a narrow eye, it gives us a wider effect.
That's really very good. Also, there might be other tricks for giving you a healthy look, a glowy look, even besides those tricks that would contour the face.
Yes, about having a glowy look.
And also contouring the area over the lips is very much in fashion.
Yes, it's for the people who wants to contour this area. Yes, people who have this area big or very wide, so we contour these two lines.
How do you do that?
With the contour, the two lines over the lip. We just go over them with the contour and blend it in, so when you look, you find the contour, you don't find this area wide.
Why am I saying that is that the reason this is going to save us a lot of cosmetic surgery or plastic surgery.
Yes.
Because instead of spending too much money about plastic surgery, and you know, the side effects and the trial and errors of plastic surgery and the risks, You could do that.
Yes.
The makeup tricks.
Yes, makeup tricks now honestly are covering everything a plastic surgeon could do.
Unfortunately, our director is informing me that we're out of time.
Okay.
That's so bad. But anyway, on a promise that you come over once
yes,
again.
Yes, we will.
And give us more tips.
Sure,
thank
that's
you
my pleasure.
So much, Miss Al-Qatari, Yumna Al-Qatari.
Thank you so
you
much.
You are a makeup artist and also a beauty expert. Thank you so
it
much.
It was my pleasure. Thank you.
Have a very good day and Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you.
Thank you. And I guess on this very note, we come to the end of the breakfast show for today. Many thanks to all of you. A Happy New Year and a Merry Christmas. And hope this year would hold all prosperity and health and wealth to you.